Otter Tail Channel.
Tom.
Hi, Tom. Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So this is the 261.
This is the 261, the Milwaukee 261.
Okay. This is normally housed in Wisconsin, isn't it?
No, housed here in the Twin Cities.
Oh, it's in the cities.
It is.
Okay. There's a rail museum or something, isn't there?
There is. That's in St. Paul. Mm-hmm. And this is over in Minneapolis, actually. Just north of the river.
Okay. Very good. Now, this, I understand, is a coal train. Is that right?
It's coal, yes.
It is coal. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's a little bit unusual for the United States, anyhow.
It wasn't when these were built, but
right.
It is somewhat now. A lot of the bigger ones, particularly the western ones, tend to be all oil-fired.
Yeah, well, I know Big Boy's oil.
Yeah. Okay. Well, Big Boy was coal, and they
converted it.
Converted it to oil.
Oh, okay, very good. All right, well, now this is a 484. And now, if I'm not mistaken, I believe this was made in 1944. Is that right? Okay, 1944. So it's been around for a little while.
It has.
What, do you have any idea what kind of shape it was in before they rebuilt it?
No, I wasn't around when they did that.
Okay. They did a beautiful job.
Well, it was over the Railroad Museum in Green Bay, so it was well taken care of before it was rebuilt by the Friends of the 261.
Okay, well, actually, considering it's still a coal train, there probably wasn't a whole lot to do to... I mean, they didn't rearrange anything. They just...
Not in a major way, no.
They just kind of cleaned everything up and made it look shiny. This is really a beautiful train. Now, I was going to stop and ask if I could see them stoke it up, but I understand you just leave these running.
You mean to fire it up?
Yeah, to fire up the engine, yeah.
Yeah, we did that before we came over here.
Okay, so it's been running for about a week now, right?
About a week and a half.
And it's just, when you're done with it, you just park it, let it idle, and have someone feed the coal. Does the coal have to be shoveled in still?
It does primarily when we're sitting at night, mm-hmm. but when we're running in the daytime, if we're running at any speed at all, we have a stoker.
Okay, is it like a conveyor belt type thing?
It's an auger.
Oh, it's an auger, okay. So no more fireman then?
Oh, yeah.
Well, of course, to start it.
That's how I get this dirty.
Are you the one that put... Now you,
and there's about five of us.
Now, you guys start it with basically twigs, right?
With what?
Twigs. Small wood.
No, we started with coal, and then you can't... It's hard to get coal to ignite. It takes a lot of heat to ignite coal.
Right.
So we put wood on top. We put the coal in first, put wood on top of the coal. Start the wood on fire. The wood will get the coal burning.
Oh, then the embers burn down into the coal then?
Yeah.
Okay. And does this one, you have a, there's the tank right there to empty the ashes, right? You have to empty the ashes,
yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah.
So this just has a tray that, and you guys.
Yeah, see these doors here?
Uh-huh.
Doors.
Okay.
That's the hopper and what's called the ash pan.
That's the ash can. You know, I noticed, I was watching one on video. And they have an air hose that they stick down in the ash can, and they said that really ignites the coal up pretty good.
Yeah, they wouldn't put it in the ash can.
Well, I saw one they did when they were like stirring up the ash in the bottom, and they said that it actually helps the coal burn hotter.
No, we've never done that.
No, okay.
No, it's most of it here, come on over here.
Okay.
That's what's in the ash. That wouldn't burn.
Oh, no. Heavens, no. Okay, and then you can see the baffles and everything?
No, not really. They're up. The grates
they're
are
up where
up
the
above.
Heat
you
goes.
Can't really see.
Sure. Okay. Well, that is fantastic.
Yeah.
How much longer do you think this thing will run? Another 100 years?
100 years? I don't know. There's a lot of things that are it's dependent on, like coal. Who knows what coal's going to do in the next 50 years?
And that's the nasty thing about it is a lot of the power plants are switching from coal to natural gas, which is killing our train line.
It's making a difference for sure.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I know that the pipeline in North Dakota, I in Perham, where my live feed is, we used to get 50 to 60 trains in a 24-hour period. And now we only get about 25 in an 18-hour period. And we think that that had something to do with the pipeline.
Power plants are changing the natural gas. Mm-hmm.
Cool. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, you're welcome.
We're inside of the 261 now. Can you guys tell me a little bit about how it runs?
Sure. I mean, it's a coal-fired engine, so it burns coal mm-hmm. to burn the water, to boil the water in the boiler.
Okay.
The boiler and the steam in the boiler goes into the cylinders.
Water from there going here, like yeah. right now, excuse me.
It's putting water.
Oh, and that moves the water. Wow.
We're adding steam to the water to overcome the boiler pressure with an injector.
Is that a pump or is that all steam pressure?
Injector.
Okay.
Steam. There's no moving parts to it.
Boy, and it's not quiet in here, is it?
It's a series of cones, and so the steam goes through the cones and increases the velocity of the steam, and then they mix the water and drops in or comes into the, you know, into that jet stream, and then that Venturi, in effect, takes, you know, say we're at 240 pounds here, takes 240 pounds, increases it to about 242, 243,
okay.
so it can overcome the check valves and the pressure in the boiler and
right.
get in there. Otherwise, you're just 200 pounds to 200 pounds isn't going anywhere.
It's not, it's just going to sit.
So
then.
That's how a steam injector works.
Okay.
As opposed to a hot water system where there's a pump that goes through a heating unit, you know, usually up on the smoke box, in the smoke box, and then that heat preheats the water, and then there's a big, huge pump that then pumps, steam-driven pump, that'll then pump it in that can generate more than the boiler pressure.
Okay.
So that's the only time you're using a pump generally is with a hot water heating system. Otherwise, you're using injectors with cold water.
Okay. Now, I see back here, here's the shovel, and there's your supply of coal. But I understand that the fireman doesn't have to shovel the whole time now, that you just get it started and then let the auger take over.
Put the auger down there.
Oh, wow.
You've got to run it so you can see it.
There we go. How about that? Oh, that's beautiful. So you don't have a great big long rod that you need to run in here to even everything out? You do still have to stir it.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so the auger just gets it in and then you guys take care of the rest.
Well, the stirring up you're only doing because there's ash or it's bridging and it's clumping together or doing, you try not to put a rake in it.
Okay.
Now a lot of times you can just use the shakers down here.
Okay.
And just give it a little shake and that'll knock whatever crust is forming off of the top and then allow it to start breathing and get air through it.
Okay, the shakers.
The only reason you really use a rake is to clean it in the morning, get the ash out, and if something's happening on the road, if you're using a rake, that means something not good has happened.
Okay, very good.
Yeah.
So, you guys have to know what each and every one of these valves and meters say and do, right?
Pretty much.
I mean, if your meters pretty much tell you everything, or...
Well, once you know the engine, once you know the steam engines, you can pretty much walk into just about anything and identify what's what.
Okay.
You know, they'll all the coal burners will have a cluster of valves here that adjust the jet.
Okay.
Individually, they'll have a main one that provides the jet to them. They'll have a stoker. If you're in an oil burner, they've got a fuel lever or a fuel valve, fuel lever, and a steam lever.
Okay.
But it's sort of the same thing. You know, every one of them is going to have a blower for the stack. You know, when you're sitting there and you're not getting draft, that gives you the fire draft. You know, the rails up there, everybody's got injectors, stokers. Those are all your shutoffs on the turret.
Well, and there's more meters over there too then.
And over there is all the engineer's side. You know, he duplicates the glass, but pretty much over on that end he's got brakes, throttle, forward reverse, bells, sanders.
Okay. And you just run the steam then?
The fireman just is responsible basically for the water in the glass and the pressure on the gauge.
Okay. Oh, how about that? So you can actually see the water there.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Very fine. Well, my goodness.
The only difference with the little tourist ones is they don't have all of this stuff. There aren't as many valves, but, you know, looking in the big boy, you can pretty much even see what all of that stuff is.
Is it pretty close to the same, big boy? They were built about the same time.
They've got a few more valves, but most of it just has to do with accessories.
Mm-hmm.
You know, train heat, lube heat, the steam heat for the, you know, in a train, they're still set up for that.
Do you know if they're the same maker or no? Because they were built about the same time, weren't they?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Thank you.
And there's the water valve. Okay, and this was 44 they built this.
44, I believe.
44, yeah.
Should all be up in there.
Oh, there we go. See if I can get a shot of that. Very fine. Well, thank you, sir, very much for your time. I greatly appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Enjoy the day. So this is the North Pole Express. This is a steamer. It's a 484, built in 1944. This is a Milwaukee train, and it's called the 261. To learn about the 261 on YouTube, go to friendsof261.com, and you can find out more about the train and give you more information about it. But just wanted to get a good look at this thing before we got it rolling.
Thanks for watching. Drop a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe.